Scott Moore, Lock Haven. First off, I ask these Clarion guys, is Clarion back? I'm going to ask you the same question. Is Lock Haven back?
Hey, Lock Haven's making a move in the right direction. You know, we're basically trying to get a lot of our young guys in the lineup, you know, seeing what they can do. But this year we got a lot of seniors, so it's kind of our year to make a run at an EWL title, a PSAC title, something that we've been looking to do for the last 10 years. And, you know, I think we're back. You know, we're still young. We're still improving. We still got a long way to go. But, you know, the last 3 or 4 years, we've been getting these guys a lot of matches. And that's kind of our strategy as coaches, as competition, getting in situations, trying to figure out, you know, what we're good at, what we got to get better at. And, you know, that's we wrestle a lot of matches, and we try to put our guys in positions to, you know, wrestle the best guys in the country. So,
no returning All-American Neff in the lineup today. I've heard he's cutting from 49 to 41, All-American to 49 last year. Is he making the cut? Why didn't we see him today?
Yeah, he's making a cut. Made weight yesterday. We did all our guys not wrestle. We had 15 guys here today, you know, about half our team, about half our starters. So, but yeah, he's making a cut to 41. Just really thinks that's going to be a good shot for him to be a national champion, you know. And, you know, you got to look at the weight class, look at the guys he's wrestled. And realistically, he didn't cut a lot of weight for 49. Wrestled well, obviously a returning All-American, but just really thinks his senior year, wants to make sure that he's getting to the right weight class that he can be on top of the podium, not just, you know, on the podium. So,
good performances today out of Sponsler. He wins at 184. Sprinkle loses a match in overtime to Nye of UVA. Who a guy, you probably coach, did you coach Nye at all?
No.
Did you were out, you were after that. Yep. But you guys had finalists there. Rem's a finalist at 33.
Yep.
And you know, you guys had some good performances today.
Right.
What do you take out of, what do you say to your guys after today?
You know, this is our first opportunity to get on the mat and kind of see what we need to get better at. A lot of these guys came in with a good strategy as far as, you know, Sprinkle making it to the finals with a couple really good wins over a kid from Buffalo and a kid from Cleveland State and Wheeler, and you know, had a real good game plan against Nye, who's you know, top 10 kid at 197, and you know, almost finished the takedown at the end of regulation, ended up going to the fourth ride out, and you know, couldn't get out. But guys like him that, in my opinion, are sleepers, especially at that weight class. Guys are big, strong kids, smart, good game plans. Guys have been around for a while. You know, I think those guys are going to get on the scene here and, you know, compete to be All-Americans this year. Sponsler, a freshman for us, very highly touted recruit, first, second, third in the state in high school. Wrestled at 97 last year, had about 26, 27 wins. He got down to more of a natural weight for him at 184, made it to the finals, had some good wins throughout the day. You know, another guy in the lineup, a young guy that we expect to be a big contributor for us this year. You know, then the other guys, I mean, we came to wrestle the best, and that's what we ended up doing. You know, we lost a lot of close matches to guys from Virginia today, which was frustrating being my old school. But, you know, we came to wrestle the best. We got to those guys in a bracket, whether it was the semis or the finals. You know, our guys put up a great fight. We lost a lot of close matches. But, you know, all in all, our younger guys, a lot of great wins too. Cody Cords and Corey Hazel and some of these younger guys that were, you know, great in high school as freshmen, they came and competed and beat some studs today. So overall, we're happy with, you know, where we're at and, you know, where we're headed.
Aaron McKinney, in my opinion, has no purpose losing that match. Two, I mean, he's got the guy lifted up in the air. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's in on like three super deep shots, can't finish any of them, and then gets in not typical Pennsylvania fashion. He gets ridden.
Rode out, yeah.
And what do you say to that guy who, I think that guy's a total sleeper.
Yeah, you know, he's cutting down to 57 this year, looks really lean. I think he felt better at 57, felt stronger. Just didn't get it going that match, being late in the day. I don't think he picked up his intensity till later. Like you said, had three shots he could have finished, had a single leg up in the air. But that's stuff we got to work on. You know, we got to test these guys against the best guys, and you're not going to win them all, you know, but it's what you take from the tournament. And I think we know that he's a competitor this year, somebody who's, you know, a top 20 kid at 157, but we got to win those close matches. I mean, if you're going to get in the rankings, if you're going to be at the national tournament, you got to win the close matches, and we're going to go back and look at the film, and whether it's working on bottom, finishing shots, it's stuff we got to get better at.
Josh is at Cleveland State now, your twin brother, and you guys are pretty fierce rivals, I'd say. Him being across the way now in the PSAC, no, not in the PSAC, but he's going to be across the way in the dual meet, in the tournament, NCAA tournament. Can we see an all-out Moore brother brawl?
You know what? You know, they're doing a good job at Cleveland State. You know, they had some really good wins today with the younger guys, and we're in a lot of recruiting battles now that he's at Cleveland State, recruiting a lot of Pennsylvania kids up there. You know, but I don't know if we'll be scrapping out anytime soon. Last time I hurt him pretty bad, so I kind of felt sorry for him. He's my little brother, so
I think born the win. First. Were you born first?
Yeah, 10 minutes. So okay. Win goes.
And you were upperweight too. You're 41. He was 33.
So a little bit.
So you
of
are the
difference.
Big brother.
A lot more hair. So
I wasn't going to bring it up.
Just a dominating performance.
All right, you got anything else for me?
That's it, man. Let's get after it.
All right, hey, thanks for the time. Thanks.